My name is Eline Binnick. I'm an assistant professor at the Department of Medical Ethics and Philosophy of Medicine at Erasmus Medical Center in Rotterdam, the Netherlands.
Should genetic tests for AMD be offered by commercial companies directly to consumers, or should tests be offered by hospitals and only available to individuals through their physician or treating ophthalmologists?
When we're thinking about the way in which such tests could be offered, I have not any principled objections against companies offering genetic tests directly to consumers, but the first generation of testing companies were having some problems with accurate or reliable predictions. So they were using only a limited set of SNPs, only a few or maybe a handful of variants, and that inherently will sketch an incomplete, incomprehensive picture of somebody's risk. For instance, I myself have done a test through a DTC company a couple of years ago, and I found that my risk compared to the average population risk of 7%, that was their estimate, was then 1%. But then again, this is probably not a very accurate risk factor, or risk estimation. And I'm also thinking about, you know, 30 years from now, maybe when we do have effective treatments for AMD, what if I remember this test result? And what if I grow up and believe that I will not be developing AMD in my lifetime? I may even develop symptoms and then not go to a doctor on time because I have a faulty idea that I will not be developing AMD. So I think that there are some risks involved with offering these tests on a commercial or direct-to-consumer basis, and companies should be very clear about also the limitations of their tests and provide accurate information to consumers.
What are the ethical aspects that need to be considered when offering these tests?
Well, when I think about ethical issues when it comes to genetic testing for AMD, I'm thinking about two different domains of application. One is in the clinic, where people may have symptoms, they have a problem, they go and see a healthcare professional on their own initiative. For these people, it could be very worthwhile to know what exactly the type of AMD they have and what the prognosis is. So maybe if genetic testing can help establishing that much more accurately, then that is a great benefit, I think. I think there are probably more ethical issues associated with offering these tests as a screening test to a healthy population, especially because AMD is a serious disease and it can have a major impact on somebody's everyday functioning and quality of life. And then if you're completely healthy and you have no problems and you hear that you have a seriously increased risk of developing such a disease, I have seen prediction models that can give results ranging from maybe 1% or 0% absolute lifetime risk or 65%. And when I'm thinking about the 65%, that's more than half. So if you hear such a thing, you're much more likely to develop the disease than not to develop the disease, and that can be like a sword of Damocles above your head, especially because as of yet we don't have very many effective preventive or treatment options for AMD, most types of AMD. And that can have a major impact. So I think that's something that we should really be thinking about, whether we want to offer that as health professionals, and also for patients or consumers. They should be thinking about, would you want to know such a thing, especially if there's not much you can do?
What should the patient be informed about before ordering a genetic test?
I think that providers, when they offer genetic tests, especially predictive genetic tests, they should be very clear about the limitations of the test. Also, they should be very clear about the risks and implications of receiving a test result, because there is no way of unknowing, of not knowing something about future genetic risks that you, if you know it, there's no way to go back. And this can have a great impact on people's lives. So that is something that that needs some time to understand, to find out what it is that a patient or a consumer or a citizen may be getting into when they're doing this type of testing.
What are the legal consequences of genetic testing in the Netherlands versus the United States of America?
From what I read and hear, when people think about genetic testing, they are sometimes concerned about genetic discrimination, about discrimination based on genetic information. And this seems to be a problem, a public fear in many different countries. I do think that maybe doctors and patients need not fear genetic discrimination that much. In the Netherlands, for instance, we have a universal healthcare system, which actually covers the insurance that is mandated, covers almost everything that is medically necessary. Also, health insurers are legally bound to accept patients regardless of their disease status or their genetic risk. In the US, a couple of years ago, a law was passed, GINA, Genetic Information Non-Discrimination Act, which prohibits employers and insurance companies from using genetic information for their decisions. And I think especially the American law provides adequate protection against genetic discrimination. But there have, of course, been incidents. There have been cases in which patients who were maybe chronically ill or had a genetic risk were not able to obtain life insurance, for instance. And probably and unfortunately, this is likely to happen again, but it is not very common. So a lot of people fear genetic discrimination, legal consequences of genetic testing, but it doesn't seem to be a very widespread, very common problem. Not in the Netherlands and not in the US. In the Netherlands, for instance, we have life insurance companies that have self-regulated and accepted a moratorium on using genetic information or asking questions about any genetic tests that have been done in the past. So below a certain financial threshold, no questions are asked. It seems that these fields are adequately regulated. And we sometimes see that patients refrain from undergoing genetic testing out of fear, but that is not something of course you have to be aware of risks, but that doesn't seem to be necessary.
Can results of genetic testing be used for research purposes?
I do think that when test providers, providers of genetic tests, maybe on a commercial direct-to-consumer basis, when they want to use the genomic data that they've obtained through selling tests, basically, when they want to use that data also for research, they will have to ask for informed consent, just like what we know from biomedical research by health professionals or by researchers. I don't think that there should be a major difference in standards of ethical guidance with regard to the use of genomic data. You also see that on an international level, there are developments to further strengthen the position of consumers or citizens to control what other parties are doing with their data. And I think that especially genomic and genetic data, because it contains a lot of information not only about yourself, but also potentially about your family members, is something that deserves adequate protections. And so this means that companies shouldn't be able to use your data for their own research purposes or commercial or whatever purposes without an explicit consent. And that means that consumers will have to be informed about why and when and in what ways their data are being used, and they have to authorize that use. Thank you for inviting me to talk about these issues with you, and I hope that I have helped to give you some points for a fruitful discussion later on.